Man, it was a crazy day. And we're talking major reversals in all directions. Clarity in one area only created really smoke and more questions in another area. Keep in mind, there were some winners. Energy surged. In fact, it rallied to its highest level in 2018. Utilities also a little bit higher. Investors seeking some safety there. The Dow Jones Industrial Average, though, was indicating down 200 points early. This is early pre-market open. And then the White House said Congress would vet potential Chinese investments in the United States via a bulked up CFIUS process. It's already in place. It already works. Soon after that, the Dow's higher. In fact, at one point, we were almost 300 points higher. And then the rally began to fade. Initially, I think it were comments that Larry Kudlow made on Varney and Company suggesting that China hasn't really done much to soften their stance. But then later on, it really seemed like something else was spooking this market. First, of course, you had the tech-led NASDAQ. It collapsed. And then the S&P 500 slipped into the red. And finally, the Dow, which benefits most from global trade, it stumbled. I think professional investors probably looking at that yield curve, the 10 and 2-year yield, they both declined, but the gap between them got closer. That means the dreaded inversion is closer. And just all you have to know about this is, according to Wall Street, inverted yield curves are considered a surefire predictor of recessions. I personally don't see a recession, not this year or next year, but something is gnawing at this market. Melissa Armo, Stock Swoosh, is going to help us with that, along with David Nelson, Bell Point Asset Management Chief Strategist. All right, Melissa, what's gnawing at this market?
Just the uncertainty of what's going on with tariffs. As we've discussed before, the market doesn't like tariffs. The market loves Trump, but they don't like tariffs, and we don't know what's going to happen. Any news that comes out, whenever Trump tweets anything about China or tariffs, it creates a havoc, and the market just goes haywire.
Did you think this morning's news was pretty solid news, unfortunately, Steven Mnuchin made worse when he suggested we were going to stop all foreign direct investments. But, the idea that at least Congress is going to be in charge of this part takes away the element of surprise and the element of a wayward tweet.
But we were down. If you got up, I was up early this morning, 5 a.m., we were down. We were down big time
this morning. So my point is, we made a 500-point reversal up. Why did we lose it?
Well, I mean, just what I said, the uncertainty of everything. Every time somebody talks, the man that was talking on Varney, every time somebody says something, nobody knows what to do. So people are up. The market's been rallying. Stocks have been rallying. The tech you talked about, people are taking profits. That's what's happening. It's profit taking.
David?
I think it's less about policy and a lot more about the message and the way the message is delivered. In every war, in every strategy, the generals are going to have maybe opposite opinions, but eventually the commander-in-chief makes the final decision. That conversation should take place in the White House and not in the press, and unfortunately that's where it's taking place, and that uncertainty is causing people to hit the sell
button. You don't feel that maybe something else could be at work here and that the tariff thing is an easy reason? Let's face it. With the advent of financial television, every day there's got to be an official reason. But sometimes we learn later other things were at work.
There's obviously something wrong right now because you got big divergences out there. You've got estimate revisions going through the roof. You have Fed officials tripping over themselves as to just how high the GDP will be. Yet global cyclicals versus defensive right now crashing through the floor. There's something wrong. One of those two charts is wrong.
Red flag or yellow flag? What's happening for you right now?
I give it a yellow flag right now. We're in purgatory right now, and investors aren't sure which way we're going.
You've been saying this is the way it's going to be throughout the summer. So are you still feeling that way? And how vulnerable are we to breaking some key support numbers?
We're pretty close. We're pretty close in all the indices right now. And as I said before, the banks look horrible. I mean, if you look at Goldman Sachs today, man, that stock is so close to breaking major support, almost in a downtrend. I mean, I haven't seen it look this bad in so long. You're not going to have the market. You're not going to have a strong market without the financials. You need them to lift the market up.
Yeah, I think without a doubt, that's been the most
disappointing. You need both tech and financials. Yeah. Those are the two main
legs of the stool. And financials have been in terrible condition all year long.
Yes.
Thank you both very much. Well, the cycle of fake news and how the public perceives the media has become something of an epidemic. We're going to break down an astonishing news study that you probably already knew, but it's going to be fun talking about it anyway.